Hey, Mommy. How you doing, Miss Lyla? You got a Reese's cup? You eating a Reese's cup today? Look at you. You see, it's me, Jimmy. Yeah. Let me try to add somebody. Hey, Diane. You're the only one on. I've had trouble with this thing today.
Oh.
So, Mom is up. She's eating a Reese's cup.
Mom?
Yep.
I got to stay up. This better be so bad, Jimmy. I think I'm going to break the battery. You can't replace the battery.
Right.
I'm trying to call a charger, but I'm going to look and make sure that Kristen is not right. Then I'm just going to order a phone. I was trying not to bother with damn phone.
So the only person I can't get, let me try to get Jason. Yes, Sharon. Trouble with the line today, Sharon. How you doing?
Hi, hi, Jimmy. Hi, Diane. Hi, Mom.
Let me tell y'all real quick. The doctor just called. The EEG they did for epilepsy came back negative.
That's great news.
Yeah, so they don't know what was wrong, but it's not. It wasn't. They don't think it was the heart. At least now we don't know that she doesn't have any kind of neurology.
Because yeah. That epilepsy did run in the family.
It does. Look at David. Look at Big Mike.
Yeah.
Fatherly brother.
Uncle Kristen had it.
I think Ezra has it too, though.
He
Ezra
might.
Ezra Hunter.
Yeah.
Because he had some kind of seizure when he hit his head. They think he was having a seizure and hit his head on the thing.
And you want to go around and say hi to Mom?
So yeah, we better in case get
turn. Well, yeah. Uh-huh. Put your face on the screen. I'm blowing you up so you can speak to Mom.
Oh, she's talking my phone and it's quick though. Okay. I'm ready.
Go ahead.
Hey, Mom. Can you see me?
Oh, boy.
Hi, Mom.
Yeah.
Okay. Look at me.
Yeah.
Can you hear me, Mom?
A Reese's cup.
Oh.
See, I told you her roommate shares a candy with Mom.
Yeah, we got somebody else will come on the line so we can decide about the box and the market.
Well, I just made you big, Diane. Go ahead and speak to Mom.
Mom. Hey, Mom.
Yes.
Mom, it's Diane.
Hi,
Mom.
Hi.
You see me? I think she see me, Jimmy. Look at me, dude, in the face.
And she was smiling when she was eating that candy bar.
Yeah, come on now.
And she fed herself. She still got the wrap in her hand.
That's why I was looking to see what she was holding on to.
Oh, yeah, so she knows what to do now.
Hey, Ma, where's your picture? Where's Mama's picture?
Oh, that's supposed to come in the room every day and show it to us. So I don't know if they did today or not.
Look, Jimmy, you're going to be getting a call from Christian soon.
What happened?
We was talking about the poops over at his house Saturday. We was talking about the picture. You're like, I need one. I'm like, Christian, I said, you can put a copy of mine when I go get it. And put it on his wall in his house.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Mom. Lyla.
Yeah.
Lyla. Hi, Miss Betty. Uh-huh. Hi, Miss Betty.
She's responding.
Yeah, because she said us one. I'm all good. That's good. Glad you're doing good. How you doing, Miss Lyla? Miss Lyla? Miss Lyla Leola?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Jimmy.
No, go ahead, sir.
Mom?
She gained a little bit of weight.
That's because she don't have a, you know what?
Oh, okay.
And I've never seen that shirt before.
I
can't look at the baby length away.
Yeah.
Mom, Miss Lyla? Miss Lyla?
Let me try Jason one more time. So nobody said nothing today, so.
Hey, Mom.
Well, I try to get everybody. We've had a bad connection, so I don't know how much time we're gonna get because the thing won't let me type anybody's numbers in. So I had to. But what I found out, like if you put on FaceTime at about 3:15, you should already see an act. You might already see an active screen.
Oh.
Because we've done this so many times, it's kind of weird. Like when they called me, one time they called me and all your numbers popped up automatically. I didn't have to do anything. It doesn't happen all the time, or each time it's something. Because they changed the iPads around.
Right.
And so some of them are set up differently than others. So you just kind of watch it. If you don't hear from me, just click on, don't dial it, don't dial me, but just click on FaceTime and see what happens.
Yeah.
And by the way, they didn't send out a report, but I talked to Steve Wynn, and he said, you know, they have a negative. There's still nobody getting sick at this point, and they're testing the staff every week. They test the staff. That's the whole staff, so they can almost pinpoint it down there. Because nobody's coming into my room but staff people.
Right. Maybe someday they'll allow us to.
I don't know. At some point, we have to just hope that this thing will blow over. Every time, part of the problem is half the population don't think it's real, so they're just doing what they want to do. And the young, some of these millennials just don't know no better. I'm so disappointed in that age, that demographic. I don't know what to say about that.
So listen, Jim, let me tell y'all this real quick while they're not in here. But I talked to Mike about not wanting the kids to be hanging with his family, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, the grandfather died of the virus back in April, so I don't want y'all in the house. I don't want my grandkids. I don't care. His half-sister, they had the same fault, different mother, would be somebody within a club, somebody within a bar, somebody in a restaurant. This is her. Somebody is at the friend with no mask or never mask.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not there the day that they got it. He's like 29 or 30 years old. She just got diagnosed. I told Mike, I don't want the grandkids over your mother's house. I don't even want them over your grandmother's house.
Yeah.
Right?
That's right.
She's one of the people that was like, oh, I'm young, I can fight it off. You can fight it off, but your grandmother who has kidney disease can't fight it off.
Right.
But we just had this conversation this morning. This mother want to see them. They can't go. You know, they're my kids and grandkids. They don't need to go. Donovan and McCown are asthmatic. Don't set yourself up for that.
Right. And that's a bronchial disease. So if they've already got some problems, it's going to make it worse.
They have chronic asthma. Yeah. You know, some of the best year in his lifetime because he ain't had a car.
Wow.
He can't be going around. Don't let it collect everything. You can't be going around with that. He just got diagnosed within the last 2 or 3 days. I see her on Facebook Facebook every day, so he's here, she's there, she's everywhere. That's why I have gotten better. They're not taking it seriously.
What is my mom looking at that? She looking at that rapper.
Well, she is.
And she looked right up as soon as she said, hey, Mom.
Mom, what do you want us to bring you, Mom? What you want us to send? But tell us what you want right now. We're going to get it to you. What you want?
Some candy.
You want some more Reese's Cups? Reese's Cups. Miss Betty, you got any more Reese's Cups? Yeah. You got any more candy?
Yeah, we got some.
You got some? Okay. Thank you. Can I have it? It's a crazy situation, ain't it, Ma? It's crazy, isn't it? But that was nice of somebody gave you a Reese's cup today.
I'll get it. I don't know somebody. I know what mine was. Hey, Mom, you want some money? How much money?
What's the money? I've been some money, Sharon.
We sure do.
Shut up.
Yeah. Miss Bay, you tell me to shut up. It's your nephew.
Don't shut up for laughing at her.
It's your nephew.
Huh?
It's your nephew.
What was his name?
Gregory. See, you're laughing too. You know this is Gregory. Mom is still smiling.
She's looking dead in the camera.
Yep. So she must see. That one time she actually waved. You gonna wave at me, Mom? You see me? I see you. You gonna wave at me?
Be smiling.
Yeah, wave that right hand. You see this ugly face? She waved one time before. She's gonna wave today. You gonna wave at us? Everybody's waving.
See me.
Hey.
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 Can I see the baby?
Oh, well.
It's Lyla, baby.
I see a lot of
Lyla's baby.
No, but you know what? That picture's been around, Sharon.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how it got out, but it's been I think at one point she might have actually posted on Facebook.
What picture?
Of Uncle Braxton and they looking into one of those like dime store photo booths. It's a little picture like that.
April.
Yeah. But you know what? She doesn't know anything about Braxton Jr. No, she said one time it came up in the conversation. She does not know. It was up her older brother. He was the firstborn, and he died. But she did not. She apparently never told her about it because she said I ain't never had no brother, so I left it alone. She had it was Braxton Jr., little light skinned curly boy. And he died as a toddler.
I remember him.
Yeah. Diana remembers.
Yeah, Diane
remembers it.
I was sitting in the car.
Yeah.
We was going to the morgue.
What?
You know that her daughter died, right?
Yeah. Yeah. But April's not the oldest. April's the second born.
Right.
Yeah, but that she was one told me that she never had any brother, but just her.
Right.
Sister.
Nope.
And I didn't say nothing. She won't hear it from me.
Look at mine. Look up again.
Maybe because you said grass.
Yeah.
Grass. Let me see.
Do rats still living, right?
Right.
Yeah. And look, it's just like mine. He look exactly like mine with a mustache.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him in about 40 years, I believe.
It's terrible. He look good for his age. We saw him last year.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you might see him
today, Diane.
You don't know.
You hear what Miss Betty said. Hey, sure. Uncle Juett is a nice guy. He's a nice guy. Can you hear me? Diane, tell you, we were talking to him. And he said something like, when his son passed away, he said, well, I thought about him today. And that was it. That was it.
Hey, Miss Betty, let me ask this baby question. Hey, Miss Betty.
Try it again, because she didn't, must not have heard you.
Give me a number, hey, Miss Betty. I want to play lottery. Give me a number. Hey, give me a number.
What's that?
I'm looking to see if Mom reacted to that at all.
You know how you go and you play the
What was mom number was 823, wasn't it?
823, yeah.
Yep.
Beautiful.
And she went right at it. I watched her eat it, but you know, she took it out the wrapper, you know, and ate it. And she ate it all. She didn't waste any of it or nothing. So eye hand coordination still works good.
Oh yeah, that's
true. Yeah, so she knows when it comes to her food, you know, she does all right.
Well, I think we'll have to do two boxes then, one for her and one for her.
Well, it would be nice if we did that. We got to just figure out how we're going to do it. So we can't, you know, we can get together at some point. We'll either on the FaceTime or through the group text. But we'll see.
What can we get her to stimulate her?
Well, I'm going to remind them that I'm going to ask, maybe tomorrow I will call Miss Prince and say, Miss Prince, you guys still coming in every day with the pictures? Because that's talking to mom, you know, giving her a little one-on-one time and with that picture, see if we can gel something in her memory. But that the woman, the little white woman, Miss Lily came, she called me directly. She got the number from Miss Prince and called me and said, Mr. Dupree, I just left your mother. So I never seen her respond like that. Said mom was pointing and grinning and laughing at the picture, so she must have recognized it.
Of course.
Yep. So if they do that, if they're going to do that every day, or at least when they all have activity time, and I imagine they got to spread that out now because they got to do it one-on-one with people instead of bringing them all in a room at one time. But at least if a couple times a week they're engaging mom and talking to mom and showing her that picture, that's going to help.
Well, you know, as we they cut out the external activity people coming in.
Right.
So I'm performing like 6 or 7 of the different kids. Never got around to where mom is because they went to construction and Miss Desi said, wait until after they finish construction.
Yeah.
But they do look forward to people coming in, you know, friends.
Mm-hmm. No.
Nobody can come in now.
But y'all could do your famous talent show dance. You, Sharon and Diane, you two could do your famous talent show dance. Because you could start practicing that now and be ready for it. Yep, heard through the grapevine. I remember the song then. I taught y'all that dance. Twist and spin around and clap. Spin around and clap. Two steps to the right, clap. Two steps to the left.
To be able to understand your
clarinet. I'm still embarrassed when I think about it. Playing Silent Night with a sport coat on.
Huh?
Oh, they had a big giant hook to catch me and drag me off the stage. That was the worst. But that was at their suggestion. So, what the heck. In the end, it's just made me the person I am today. I'd be damned if I play a clarinet anywhere in public. Oh, it was a lot of fun. And the little band, remember they had some little job band? They were like the worst band in the history of bands. But because they had a little beat going, that's all that matters. Them people going crazy.
Remember, David
won
a talking toy.
Yeah, what did they do to get something?
I think they pulled a name. It's
yeah, because cool. I think the three of us were the only ones that got roped into doing something silly.
Yeah, they pulled his name like out of a
head
and they called his
stuff
and he ran.
Yeah. What was that song you were playing on
the Friday night, Jimmy? Silent Night. Because it was a Christmas talent show. So I don't even know if I was in the competition. I think I was just part of like the entertainment. Like, go out there and play Silent Night.
Do y'all remember when mom and dad had stuffed dinner in the house and cereal and sandwiches and
all? You breaking up, sir, and something happening.
Do you remember when mom and dad started selling dinners in the house one day?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, our sister remember they had a house. They cooked it in the kitchen and turned and put like a countertop up and took all the furniture out from downstairs. I don't know what they was doing, but it worked.
Yeah, they made some money that
day. They must have made a lot of money because Uncle Duet and Braxton moved into the basement and didn't come out for about 2 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah, because they moved some of the stereo downstairs. It was kind of wild. I don't know what exactly was going on. That was like the house was completely in disarray for a minute. Uh-oh, that was Maya. Okay, well, that was, we had a nice little visit, and you gave us some extra time, it looks like. Even, so,
she sure did.
And then she looks at you and smiles. So we do appreciate everything.
Not a problem.
Thank you so much.
Okay. You're welcome.
Okay, you take care, Mom. See you later, Mommy. I'm going to have to run too, everybody. I got somebody ringing my doorbell.
He laughing.
Okay. So I'm going to hang up. I'll talk to you a little later.
All right.
All right. Bye-bye, everybody.